everybody, Wyatt-Andrews-Workshop here, and welcome back to a beautiful evening in Gold Coast Aquarium. I think it's been even longer since we've had an episode in this project since Orwell, just because this summer and fall of this year I was really burnt out of the project. I was sort of lacking inspiration, but now that I'm home from college, it's sort of the rush of it just sort of came over me, and I was like, I think we should give this little project more attention. So here we are back in GCA. We have a brand new exhibit to show off, but as usual, I'm never happy with anything. So I made a lot of changes since the last episode, starting with the entrance hangar. You'll notice I actually just added the name of the park and not just the big letters, which was what we had before. But coming through, well, actually, as sort of talk about the elephant in the room, you'll see these shadows going over. These vultures are from the safari pack, but, you know, just because there's no old world vultures in California, I placed them pretty up high, so you can't really tell exactly what species they are. But I think it adds, like, a ton of life to the area just to have, like, birds flying over it. So, yeah, I just thought that was pretty neat. And then heading inside the entrance hangar, I've added some extra decorations to sort of make the space feel more alive and I guess like a little less empty because as you can see, I'm still kind of struggling to figure out what exactly to put in here on this side. I'll probably do like a temporary exhibit similar to what we have over here, but yeah, that's still a work in progress. But in the meantime, we've added a ton of flags and some banners with some just sort of generic buzzwords. And then, speaking of the temporary exhibit, I overhauled it a bit, added some of the signs from Lion's like modular info board pack that are absolutely freaking amazing if you haven't picked that up already. It's, I think, absolutely essential if you want to make some convincing signage. And you can like recolor all of this stuff, so it's super easy to use, and it's like sort of very broad in its application. And then I've added some extra billboards, got some paleo art by R.J. Palmer and Andrea Tuchin. These are Leviathan and Bacillosaurus respectively, which are both extinct whale genera. But yeah, since it's the holiday season, I've also got some decorations in that going, got some Christmas trees. What's going on with the lighting over here? Oh, right, yeah. We'll talk about that in a second. But, yeah, I've also got, I think before this was a picture of Big Sur, California, which is where the project is set. But now I've taken a screenshot of the actual park, and I think it works much, much better. But, yeah, turning on daytime as we head outside, we have the entrance plaza, and I think I did this last year, too. Just added a nice Christmas tree in the middle, got some neat string lights going, and then I did a solid overhaul of the tide pool area. I'll put up a picture of what this looked like before, but it wasn't nearly as like appealing, I think. But yeah, we've recolored the rocks, added some more signage, and then added a brand new area back here, the Gardenia Galleon, which is just a little snack stop for people to get all kinds of stuff. We've got some really nice flowers sort of draped over these shade structures. I really like how these came out. But yeah, it's just a pretty simple, pretty cute little area. I just wanted more like quick service eateries around the park. And come to think of it, we don't actually have a bathroom either. So I definitely had to, I'll definitely have to add that somewhere. Okay, so on to the second level of the aquarium. We come back to the Otter Creek Challenge Trail. There was like a custom font, like Otter Creek, but the piece count was too heavy. Like I couldn't really, like it was so much I like, could barely place anything down. So I've removed that. But what I plan to do to replace it is get like a billboard and like put the design on the billboard and then like trace over the billboard with font pieces, which is what some people have been doing with their signs, like Lion and Even. But yeah, coming through the challenge trail, I've redone the firewatch tower for the Fisher Falls canopy run, because before it was just a little bit clunky. It was sort of too large, and yeah, this just didn't look very good, so I redid it, and this is directly based on one at California Adventure in the Grizzly Peak area. And then, yeah, you'll notice a lot of the signs are missing, and that's because I'm just overhauling the signage using some of Lion's info boards. But, yeah, this is the, as of now, untouched Pacific Fisher exhibit from a couple episodes back. But now you can get up into the Firewatch Tower and take the canopy run, which is just the ropes course. But we will see that from a couple other angles going forward. And then, yeah, this is all brand new. Let me adjust the lighting because it's much better like that. So yeah, this is, we'll see what's in here in a brief moment, but I do think this area is looking a lot better now that we have all of this going on this side, because before it was just empty besides the ropes course, which I mentioned was actually by Beyondrew TV, but you know, I just thought I would borrow it just because we've worked together so much. And then, yeah, you've probably already guessed, but this is a new Beaver exhibit because we have these guys in the North America DLC now. So I just figured, because they're semi-aquatic and do occur in California, or at least in the northern parts of it, it'd be a perfect fit here. But yeah, they've got a neat little exhibit up against the Golden Forest Pavilion, but I've painted the wall like blue just so it sort of blends into the sky a little bit and isn't too it doesn't stand out too much, but yeah, I'm gonna go inside of this little beaver dam or this beaver lodge that kids can crawl through and just sort of play around in, but then they can come out on this side and check out these terrariums as well as another view into the beaver's pond. What I really love, I think this came with either the Africa Pack update or the North America Pack update, is that you can now, like, recolor the glass panels. So, before they were just kind of this, like, milky, like, milky's kind of a weird word, but it was very, like, the glare was very intense, but now, you can recolor it black. So now that, like, clear, it's, like, perfectly clear. It's really, really, really cool. And I did the same for these. We've got a terrarium for a Pacific chorus frog, as well as a tiger salamander, which are both amphibians that occur in California. And yeah, I really love how the ropes course kind of goes over this whole thing. And then I want to talk about all these logs, which are part of a mod by, I have it right here, Jojo2958. He made a generic zoo scenery pack. And it includes a lot of the logs you see here. This is custom, but like this one, and this one, and this one, these are all part of it. They're all just dead trees that we've been like sorely lacking, which is why I made these logs in the first place. But now we have like an actual model for it, which is really wonderful. So shout out to Jojo for making those. And then we will head back through the Beaver Dam and out into the main viewing areas that guests of all sizes can access. So we have the main viewing into their pond. I really, really tried like getting the diving to work, but I think it's actually 2 meters. Hold on, look. Here we go. Almost, but before it was like 6 meters deep because I really wanted them to dive, but even then they didn't, so I sort of just gave up and made this, like, to guest level, so, now it's just like that, but, I do still really love how this looks. I love all the different types of rocks, both official and modded, and yeah, it's a really nice variety, and then I've got some mud walls going around the whole thing, and then, this is a technique I picked up for both Ruble and Remnant, just sort of different parts of it. So the Ruble part is using like a base game rock, in this instance the Tiger Rock, and then coloring the faux trunks to that color. So now you can sort of like mix in those different textures without it contrasting against each other. And then the Remnant part of it is sprinkling these sort of faux rock pebbles into it, just to sort of make it feel like there's sort of different like types of rock in these sort of mud walls. So I think that is I would highly recommend doing it that way, because that's sort of what I think looks best. But, you know, everyone has their sort of own technique with it, and that's just sort of the way I've come up with based on other people's. And then we've recycled these viewing canopies from other parts of the challenge trail, so we have it for the plovers and then the otters as well. I'm still redoing, like I said with the fishes, I'm still redoing all of the signage in these areas, so that'll look different at some point. But yeah, we continue down the sort of beaver trail. You get this pretty narrow, naturalistic path, and then fun little windows into the beaver exhibit. And they like swim around like super frequently, so you can see them from pretty much everywhere. And then we get into a final viewing canopy, and you can see the ropes course like going over the whole thing and the birds circling overhead, which all comes together really, really nicely. But yeah, that's pretty much it for now. In terms of other plans, this is where the ropes course ends, if you'll forgive all of the signs. And the sort of last area in the challenge trail is going to be like a big, like, hollowed out redwood trunk with a slide going around it, and the slide is going to be colored yellow, and it's going to be themed to the banana slug, which is a species endemic to the temperate rainforests of California, and there's going to be like a little terrarium for them in the middle, and I'm really excited to do that. But for now, this is what we've got, just because I wanted to get another episode of GCA out there. We'll probably have another one pretty soon as we wrap up the Otter Creek Challenge Trail, and then it'll be on to the Baja California Sur building, and then I'm redoing this area. If you remember, there was a stingray touch pool here, but we're gonna redo that, and there was actually a sea otter exhibit in here for a brief period of time, but coming back, I did not like how that looked, so that'll all be rehauled. There's going to be like a stadium in here, and I think it might be indoors. I think that'll look really cool with like a big glass like overhead window. But yeah, all in all, business is good in GCA, and as well as Orwell. I've been actually hard at work on a new section in Orwell that I've sort of surprised myself with, because I've only had like that file for a couple of days after Lion gave it to me, but I've been super inspired after not having it for a little bit. So yeah, all in all, things are going great in my two main projects. But as always, I'll see you in whatever comes first, and have a good one.